Hello, welcome to Epilepsy Insights. My name is Katie. This is Epilepsy Insight number 8. I am going to discuss a little further some of my seizure triggers, which include a whole list of different ingredients and foods and cosmetic products. But for me, I have found that monosodium glutamate, also known as MSG, and soy are two of my biggest seizure triggers. If I have even a food that has a little bit of either of the ingredients in them, I will have a seizure almost immediately. So it's pretty extreme. I didn't discover this until I was actually eating out at a P.F. Chang's restaurant, and their food is Asian, and it has a lot of soy sauce in it, and I had no idea about seizure triggers at the time. I was just diagnosed with epilepsy probably 3 or 4 months prior to that, and so I was going about my normal routine and eating what I wanted and doing things without thinking about it first, and I had a seizure in the middle of the restaurant with my family, including my grandparents, and it was quite a mess. Everybody tends to freak out when I have a seizure, which is understandable. It's a very traumatic event, but it did not go well, so it's thankfully in the past now, but I wanted to bring it up for those of you who may be newly diagnosed, because monosodium glutamate is found in a lot of processed foods, a lot of foods in general, and even a lot of cosmetic ingredients and products and things like that. So starting off with monosodium glutamate, you have a lot of different names for MSG. There are maltodextrin, natural flavor, carrageenan, even malted barley, and dextrose. There are, if you look up a list for the hidden names for MSG in foods, which is available on quite a different few websites, you can find the entire list. And it has probably close to 100 different names for what people will list MSG as, because it is become known as a really, really unhealthy ingredient. So people want to still keep it in their foods, but they don't want to list it as MSG because then people might not buy it. They see the name MSG and they automatically think, hey, that's unhealthy. I don't want to buy it. Forget it. So they thought, well, why don't we just do code names? And that makes it even more difficult to figure out what MSG is in your food and to figure out if it is in your food. For me, I'm often referred to as the canary in the cage, because if there's MSG in a food, I will have a seizure almost immediately. So it is a very unfortunate event, but it definitely lets us know what's healthy and what's not healthy. So bright side there. But MSG is a huge ingredient for all epileptics, because it is really, really bad for your body just in general, and it's bad for your brain. And the reason why some people are more susceptible than others is because of the blood-brain barrier. Now, the blood-brain barrier is a semi-permeable layer in your brain, and it's supposed to be strong enough to prevent any toxic molecules from going through and possibly causing more seizures and more issues, just issues in general in your brain. But the problem with the blood-brain barrier, and I will discuss the blood-brain barrier next week. This is kind of a two-part video, but it's going to be way too long if I try to discuss the blood-brain barrier and MSG and soy together. So watch for the blood-brain barrier video next week. But as far as this week goes, the blood-brain barrier, I just want to say it's already semi-permeable, but it can become weakened. So, and that's just from environmental toxins and from toxins found in food. A lot of different processed foods have ingredients that will actually, they continually bombard your blood-brain barrier, and it weakens the barrier so much so that other molecules that ordinarily should not pass through are able to pass through. So this is, if you're wondering why some people react to MSG with a seizure and others can eat it and be totally fine, that's why. So when your blood-brain barrier is more susceptible, such as mine, I have a seizure. And I mean, I have an older brother, I have a younger sister, and they're completely fine eating it. They can eat it no problem. Neither of them have seizures. And, you know, that could also be like a huge question. Why am I the one who has it? But we have done a lot of different tests, and my blood-brain barrier is definitely weak. So if you are in the same boat, you want to be really, really careful with MSG. And the same goes for soy. Now, soy is a very similar ingredient to MSG in the way that it also has a lot of different code names. Code names you often don't recognize because you can't even pronounce the name. Honestly, you look at it on an ingredient label and it looks like a different language, to be honest. So a lot of different code names for soy as well. And soy is actually also listed as tocopherol or vitamin E. Vitamin E is sourced from fat-soluble ingredients, and soybeans happen to be fat-soluble. They are fat-soluble, but they are not healthy for you. So you want to avoid soy as much as possible. This is something that I think will cause a seizure even sooner for me than MSG will. So I avoid both like the plague. It's just impossible to not have a seizure immediately following eating either of those ingredients. So, which is kind of a bummer because you have to avoid certain foods that have soy in it, such as Asian foods. Those contain a lot of soy sauce, and you're just, and for me personally, the experience that I've had, I would just say to avoid it completely. So it's really important. But a few code names for soy also include soy protein, soy lecithin, and let's see, soybean oil. So you can get a lot of different oils in your food. Sometimes you'll see corn syrup oil, or you will see, let's see what else, vegetable oil. You can also find safflower oil and sunflower oil. Now those two oils, the last two that I listed, safflower and sunflower, those are the ones you're going to want to try and look for in foods instead of vegetable oil or soybean oil. So soybean oil is pretty much the worst that you can do. So if you see the name vitamin E or tocopherol on an ingredient list, be sure to contact the product, the manufacturer of the product, and see exactly where their source of vitamin E is from, because they can get it from anywhere. And this goes for cosmetic products as well. Tocopherol is often a source, they call it a healthier preservative. Instead of using full-on chemicals, they use tocopherol, and it can be used in a lot of cosmetic products. So when you go for organic cosmetic products such as lotions or moisturizers for your face, or even skincare products that you're just using to wash and moisturize, those can contain a lot of tocopherols, and often the tocopherol will be sourced from soy because they consider it healthier. The world often considers soy to be healthier. Somehow tofu was listed as a healthier food, but tofu you're also going to want to avoid because it's just straight up soy and it's just not good for you at all. And soy, your body does not know how to take the ingredient MSG or tocopherol into the body, digest it, and get rid of it. So often these two ingredients can become stored up in your cells. And after time goes by, often you have, it's not being put out of your body. Those toxins are not being released. So it's just building up, and this can cause a lot of issues. This can also be a cause for seizures, which is the buildup of toxins in your cells. So there are a lot of different causes for this, and there are a lot of different things to look for. I know that this is very overwhelming, but I'm also going to include a companion post with this video so that you can see all of the names listed out, because I know tocopherol and soybean oil, even maltodextrin, all of these names, they're really, really crazy names. They're chemicals, and they're kind of hard to recognize just hearing me say them. So I will have them all listed out, but MSG and soy, for those of you who may be struggling with epilepsy and are looking for a way to decrease your seizure activity, these could possibly be a seizure trigger for you. Now, I list a lot of other seizure triggers in my video, Epilepsy Insight Number 2, if you're interested. And there are also a couple of articles on my blog, seizethedayblog.com, where you can find a list of seizure triggers and code names for MSG and a lot more information on all of this. So I hope this is helpful, and I hope that you can avoid these as much as possible, because overall, it's just healthier for your body. It's good to avoid these foods, even if you don't have epilepsy or another health condition. It's better for you. In fact, these foods will actually cause you to gain a lot of weight. So if you're looking to lose weight and get in shape, it's good overall. It's good for everything. It's good for your body. And it just makes sense. You know, your body, if there's an ingredient in a food that you can't pronounce or that looks like it's come from a lab, it's completely chemical, such as monosodium glutamate or maltodextrin, you're going to want to avoid it. Look for natural food ingredients such as salt and pepper and just ordinary ingredients that you can purchase at the grocery store. That's really what you want to put into your body, because chemicals are always bad. Your body has no idea. It's not made to process these ingredients. And so it causes your body to go haywire from either buildup in your cells or from being transferred to the wrong area, and your body just doesn't know what to do with it there either. So avoiding problems with food is a huge thing to do for every epileptic in your diet and your overall routine. Avoiding these types of ingredients will do you a lot of favors. So if you have any questions for me, please comment on the video or on the blog. The videos are also on YouTube now, which is exciting. And you can ask me anything, and I will do my best to answer. So thanks for watching.